And there's so many of these guys. What the heck? Okay, this is very scary. Alright, nice. It's badly damaged. I'm gonna die. What is up, guys? ZackScott here, playing The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, and today I am going to turn in some crickets. I spent some time before recording this video collecting crickets. Basically, I just walked around the field going like this, and then I was like, is there a cricket? Is there a cricket? And if there wasn't, then I would move on and do it again. I would be like, is there a cricket? Is there a cricket? And look, there's like one right there, so I would just walk up and pick it up. Easy. It was a lot easier. Thanks to everyone who gave me advice and support on this. I don't think I've been in this house. This house is kind of in the back. That tree has a lot of apples on it. Holy apples. There's a lot of apples. Okay, but what we're gonna do, I'm gonna jump in this house super duper quick, see what's going on. Is he tearing down the house? What are you doing? Hey.
Hi.
Morning there. Another day, another rupee. What are you doing? Working, as you can see. This old house has been abandoned. Everyone in Hateno village agree we should demolish it. The old owner apparently went off to the castle to report for service. Never came back, never wrote, so away it goes. I'd buy this place. Well, I'm not into real estate, so I can't help you out there. If you're really interested in this place, you're gonna need to talk to the boss. Okay, who's the boss? Hi, who's your boss? Phew, this house isn't looking any less demolished despite all this effort. What are you doing again? Working? Okay, yeah, we've... Okay. Never mind. I thought maybe you would talk to me about the boss or whatever. Hard work, huh? Yep. And I wouldn't want it any other way, to be honest with you. All right. I don't know if he's going to tell me where the boss is, but let's go check out this abandoned house. I won't actually buy it. Why is it going to be demolished? Watch this be a story of Link buying his first home and then dying in it because it just collapses. You know, it looks like that might... I could shoot that down, maybe. I don't know why I would, though. But anyway, okay, cool. So let's go turn in those crickets, and then we're going to proceed. Is it a research lab? I forget exactly what it's called, but I'm going to go on up over there after I turn in these crickets. I also got some fairies and some, like, rice by doing that. It was not that much effort at all. I'm glad I did it off camera, though, because it's going to take... It took a while. I'm eavesdropping. Dropped right in on you. Okay, anyway, they don't like me much. So is he over here? Is he just the guy looking at... Oh, no, that's not him. Hey. All right, he's over here. He's over here. I got your 10 crickets. She's going to love them. Mumble, 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 mumble. Checking everyone out today, too. What is it? I got the goods. Restless crickets. I caught, like, probably 13. You really got them? I thought you were just messing with me. Okay, so, Yep, that's 10. Thanks, I'll take them. A little something for your troubles. Whoa, 100 rupees. Wow. Right then, I'll go ahead and catch the rest of them. Then I'll take them to Prima and we'll have that date. Oh no, I stutter. All right, so that is complete. A fun little side quest. And now with that, it's true, I really saw her. Oh, oops. Sorry, who did you see? There's a girl staying up at the Hateno Ancient Tech Lab. I saw her come outside. She was right over there. It's true. But when I tried to tell a grown-up about it, they said the only people who live there are an old man and old woman. She was a Sheikah girl, I swear. No one ever listens to kids. All right. Well, I'm not too worried about it. I'll go find it with time. I had asked a guy, I don't know who. Where was he? I asked a guy for like a tour. And he started taking off. And I didn't mean to. Is that him? So he was gonna do a tour, so let's do that. I didn't notice that last time, but I talked to him.
Yeah.
You got the look of a traveler. Is this your first time in Hateno Village? Well, you're in luck because you have a lifelong resident to show you around. Yes, please.
Ah.
Okay, let's get you a good old-fashioned dose of Hateno hospitality. The shop is in my daughter's capable hands these days, so I've got a lot of time on my hands. I thought it might be nice to do... It's kind of dark for a second. I thought it might be nice to do a good turn for the village where I was born and raised, so I volunteered as a tour guide. Stick with me, and I'll show you around the best parts of this place. In fact, just a minute, I'll show you something really special. All right, I'll let him lead me. All right. This is the general store, East Wind. They sell a lot of everyday goods and even some everyday greats. And now, on with the tour. All right, I understand how this works. It's a tour. I just follow him. Oh, he's almost tripping. Maybe I'm running up too close on him. Trip him, trip him, trip him. Just kidding. I won't do it. It'll be rude to do. This is the Koji Dye Shop, known for their Hateno dyeing. I think that's how you say it, Hateno dyeing. They'll dye your clothes whatever color you like. And now, on with the tour. All right. This here is Tanpu Inn. If you need a sleep overnight, then this is the place. And now on with the tour. All right, yeah, let's keep going. We're doubling back. I've already done this. I mean, I've basically done my own, like, self-guided tour. I just saw this guy, and it seemed like he was going to show me something cool at the end, so I'm like, okay, maybe. We'll see. I mean, he's running, though. All right, where are we going? Where are we going, buddy? Why didn't we just start here? This is the clothing store, Vintes Clothing. They sell, well, I'm sure you can guess what they sell. To be straight with you, this is actually my store, so come hang out when you've got some time. Stock up here first before heading over to the Koji Dye Shop. Woo! I'm pretty much beat. Let's call this the end of the tour, yeah? Just don't have the pep for tour guiding like I used to. Was that it? Seldon's Village Stores is closed. Please come again if you like. Well, I thought he was gonna show me something really cool. Why I do that? I thought he was gonna show me something really cool. Whatever. Maybe I have to pressure him. Like, are you for real? All right, I don't know. I thought he was gonna show me something really cool. That's okay. Oh, I know. Okay, so we're gonna go to the research lab or whatever they were calling it, the ancient lab. I don't remember what it was called, but it's over here. We're gonna go over here, get this tour on the way. Not tour, but explore the rest of the village, why don't we? We haven't crossed this drawbridge really, so let's go ahead and do it, have some fun. Hello, guy. La la la. Ah. All right. Oh, yeah. I've heard so much about that girl, the ancient tech lab. The boys playing spies are looking out for her, but I don't think she's shown up here yet. All right. So they're spying, huh? Good. Keep an eye out. What's this? I haven't been in here. Hello? I just barge into people's homes. That's my style. Thankfully, no one here just owns a gun. I might be shot. We're doing this. Whoa, is that a recipe or something? It's like a... Is that a recipe? Like a lizard in one of those things? Could be a recipe. I might just have a lizard in one of those things. If I find a cauldron or whatever those cooking things are called, I'll check it out. So yeah, we gotta... It looks like we still got a decent amount of area to explore here. A little bit at least, not... Where is everybody? I guess everyone's out in the town, you know, just kind of hanging out, chilling out. What do we got here? Oh man, I did check the stats before recording this video. I forgot to thank you guys. Let's wake this person up. Hello, it's daytime. Mm-hmm. I'm here to wake you. I'm a soldier. Mm-hmm. Is it my turn already? Oh well, say not to pry, but. I have to ask, who are you supposed to be? The demands of my job mean that nights and days are switched for me, so please let me sleep just a bit more. All right, fine. what I was going to say is I checked the stats, and the first episode has surpassed 5,500 likes. It's going up rapidly, so thank you so much for your continued support. It really helps. It almost has over 200,000 views. I'll let you know when it does. Let's see. Let's go. You think there's something up here? This is like a lighthouse, almost. Not a lighthouse. A windmill. Those are different things. Interesting. It's making a lot of noise. I don't know. Let me try to climb it, I guess, right? That would make sense. All right, here we go. Don't mind me. In fact, I think I'm going to fast track this. Oh, what? Okay, hold on. Nope. No fast tracking that. I don't know if I can climb it. I don't know if I should or would or... No, there doesn't seem to be a good way in there. Can I grab onto one of these windmills? That'd be so cool. Doesn't seem like I can. All right, well, let's not worry about it. No need to climb. Just let go. Oh, boy. So, the research facility or whatever. I keep calling it something else. It's up here. There's another one of these. I guess I'll go check that out really quick. I wonder if these are powering anything, you know? And there's nothing. I don't know why they let you go into every single one of these. I get disappointed when I don't find anything in. Okay, this way is the place, right? One might think. Oh, hello. Well, you're having a nice day. Hi. What a nice breeze. It doesn't carry that tang of salt on it, though. What do you mean? Oops, I forgot we just met. I was reminiscing about my hometown of Laureland Village by the sea. The view and the air are different here in Hateno Village, but this is where my wonderful husband calls home. I count myself lucky to be able to live and work alongside such a wonderful, loving man. It's a small fishing community far to the south. I lived there before I moved here with my new husband. We had to cross the Bridge of Hylia to get here, weighted down with everything I couldn't bear to leave behind. Thinking back on it, it's a wonder either of us survived the trip. All right, cool. Good on you. I'm gonna keep moving on. Nice to meet you. I'm gonna take this road up and around, just like this. And then we'll see what's up over here. We got the pasture and the ancient tech lab. I guess I'll check out the pasture super duper quick before checking out the lab. What is up? Yes? Hello. Sigh, hello. All right. They'll pay. They'll all pay. Who will pay? What is up? Hey, you. Yes. What do you want? Oh, don't act so clueless. Although, fine. You seem harmless enough. Forgive me. I've just been on edge with all these monsters running around. They come up from Hateno Beach to steal my sheep. If someone doesn't do something soon, I won't have any left. The sheep rustlers. What do I do? What do you want me to do? I hate that gang of monsters on Hateno Beach. Which monsters? The stupid ones who attack anything that moves. Last time they showed up, I gave them a taste of my pitchfork. But I had second thoughts about following them back to their camp on Hateno Beach. I was mad enough to spit, but even maybe not mad enough to take on 7 monsters at once. Anything else you want to know? I wanted to ask about where... So I'm sorry if we got on the wrong foot. That's all. Okay, so wait, where's Hateno Beach? Where is that? It's southeast of the village. Follow the winding road and you'll be there before you know it. Okay, southeast of the village. It's well known enough that you can probably find it on a map. Come to that. Okay, nothing else. So southeast of the village. If we just take a look. You think it's like right here? Like, how do I... Oh, wow. So yeah, I just follow the road and then there's gonna be like 7... Okay. I'll keep that in mind. I'm going to go ahead and nice little stuff. I wonder if any of these ponds or lakes or even this is like a fairy thing or whatever. All right, let's take a step back. All right, I'll keep that in mind. Look at that cow chasing its tail. Hey, stop it. Oh, that's a dog. All right, cool. There are some birds. Should I be chasing birds? I mean, not chasing, but should I be... getting birds, you know? Like, should I be... Don't follow me, dog. Dog, please. Dog. Please, dog, please! Oh, God. Why did I... Okay. I hope this is... Okay. Alright, well, I got one of them. Okay. Okay, I guess I'll swim. Raw bird drumstick. Oh, yeah. Get that raw bird drumstick. Yum, yum. All right. Let's go see what else we can find. I don't know. What was that? Something popped up. Nope. Let's see. Let me go around. Maybe I'll go in here, see if there's anything to do in here. Alright. It's another typical house. Anyone sleeping? No one's sleeping. Anything, like, is this anything up here? Doesn't seem so. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna open this up. And we'll go to the research lab now, and then after the research lab, if we have time, we'll go to the beach, slay some monsters. Oh, it's a cricket. I'm just gonna kinda go over here. I'm not so sure what to do with them, but I got them. Oh. Is that a bug on there, or is that just, Oh, okay, just grass, I think. All right, anyway, we're still on our way. This little kid, is he a spy? He's spying? Is there really a girl there?
Oi!
Safaro, how do things look over there? No luck. There's nothing here. All right. Well, you know. What does this say? What does this say right here? Oh, the beach is this way. I could actually do the beach first. Let's just go do the beach first if they're here. I can swoop in, take them out. Hopefully take them out. Oh, wow. Look, there's one way over there. Hold on. Hold on. I see it. I see that way over there. It's out in the sea, basically. That's a long ways to go. What the heck? I'll mark it. I don't know if I should go to it now. Oop. That seems really far. Like, I don't think I can just glide and swim there. I might have to get a raft or something. Oh, there's one up there, too. Oh, I marked it already. Okay. How about... Can I remove that one? Well, it's marked. It's basically marked. Alright, Okay, where's this? Oh, yeah, follow the road. I suppose we'll get to the beach. We'll find a little area where there are several of them sleeping. Seven, apparently. I'll take them out. I think it's just down there. It might be. Alright, I don't know exactly where it's gonna be, but, you know, if we take a look. Alright. I mean, this looks like the beach, right? I mean, okay. Well, kind of. The beach, the bay. This whole thing, maybe? I mean, this whole thing's a beach. Technically, right? You know, that thing doesn't look so far away at this point. Alright, that might be it over there. Oh, jeez. Okay, hi. Smash. Soldier's broadsword. Alright, No. Alright. Eightfold long blade. Jeez Louise, that was big. I'm thinking it's that over there. But I'm looking for seven, so who knows? Oh, those birds. There's a crabby. I'm gonna go try to pick up the crab. Hello. I'm a crab collector. It's an iron shell crab. This crab shell is particularly hard. When cooked into a dish, its fat and meat bolster the body to increase your defense. What do you think? Just go, whoop. Nope, just one. All right. Oh my god. like electric. Okay, I don't know about this. Oh god! Oh jeez, that's freaking scared me. Ow. Oh man. Okay. Oh, what? Okay. Jeez Louise, take that. Lizel Boomerang, a curved sword favored by the Lizalfos. It can be used to attack directly, or it can be thrown like a boomerang. Okay, I'm taking that with me. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, this is not good. This isn't good. Alright, this is not good. This isn't very good. This is bad. This is bad. The bad is the opposite of good. Okay. Oh my god, there's a hole. Why am I here at night? Oh my goodness. Okay, hold on 1 second. Can we not be here next to me? Got it. Oh man. Jeez Louise. Can I do anything about this? Oh my god. Okay. Hey guys, hi. Okay, this is not good. Oh jeez. Uh-oh. And there's so many of these guys. What the heck? Okay, this is very scary. Alright, nice. It's badly damaged. I'm gonna die. Hold up. This is not good, guys. What do we have here that's good? Hasty veggie cream soup. My defensive. Yeah, that looks good. Let's eat this. Jeez Louise, what is this? Alright, that looks pretty good. Roasted. Oh boy. Yeah, let's get the shield going on. The shield action here. Okay, what is happening? Go. Oh god. Oh, you know what? Fine. Oh man, I'm hurt again. Okay. What the heck do I do? Okay. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna eat this. And I'm gonna eat a roasted acorn. Alright, this is tough. This is really tough. Okay, stop. Oh god. This is by far a very tough fight. All right, come on now. Come on. Oh jeez, okay. This is not, I don't know why I'm doing this right now. This is not good. Not good. Okay, let's eat this. Let's eat one more. God, really? Come on. Jeez, how do I do this? Okay, this is really, really tough. Like, they just are very persistent. Oh yeah, I have those. Wow. Oh god. Okay. Yeah, hi. Oh, God. Okay. Let's see. What do I have here that will work? Another fairy. Oh, my God. Oh, God, what are you doing? All right. Can they come up here? Oh, my God, do I have any arrows? No, what the? Okay, hold on, I have a fire arrow. Could be good. Is he on fire? He is. Nice. The big guy's dead. Please. What the heck? Okay. No, no, no. Okay. I have to eat again. This is one of the toughest fights ever. Eat. Let's eat an apple, baked apple. Oh my God, okay. I got him. Good Lord. Still just assaulting this whole area. Yeah, sure, enhanced Lysel's spear. I don't know what these guys are doing here. Lysel spear. Let's use the enhanced one, shall we? Rice. Oh my God. Oh, hold on. All right. Oh, what the heck? Okay, this is so tough. I don't know how else to say it. Oh my God. Hot buttered apple, sure. Sure, eat this. Oh my God. Wow. Maybe I'm getting better. Holy goodness. Okay. Who else is still here? I don't want to hurt the sheep, do I? Kind of don't. Nice, got him big time. Okay. Man, I use so much food fighting here. Okay, I'm gonna take some of theirs right here. He's gone too. There we go. The sheep rustlers. I took him out, guys. What kind of reward do I get? Because that was a tough battle. All right, open. I don't know if I was ready for that. Oh, a ruby, nice. A precious red gem mined from large ore deposits found throughout Hyrule. Rubies contain the power of fire and have fetched a high price since ancient times. So one thing that might be a good thing to do is mark this on the map, because this is what my friend Ninja Marion told me, because if I ever need to come back here and that the whole thing, you know, resets, then at least I'll know that this would be a great place to go. How do I put a mark on? It's going to stamp. Here we go. Stamp it with right here. This is a place where you want to go to fight. Makes sense, right? All right. Can I save these sheep? No, no. Just take them. Just kill them. No. Let's see what we got. What do we got here? Lots of parts. Goodness gracious. I don't know if I have fully mastered the art of fighting yet. Or if that was just a tough one. I don't know. The bombs did not do enough damage, I'm telling you. Alright, I feel like I might need a sword for this. Or what is this? Alright, that's a spear. Oh, it's, arrows are glistening. Alright, I saved a lot of travel time by editing the video, but I'm here to turn in my quest completion, basically. I'm like, hey, I did it. The sheep have calmed down. I think they get that they're... Okay, that they're not about to be snatched at any moment. Hey, sorry if I'm off the mark in asking this, but are you the one who took care of those monsters? That's right. I had a feeling. When the sheep all calmed down, I thought maybe he did it. So it seems I owe you some thanks. This isn't much of a reward, but hey, in light. It's light. That counts for something. Fresh milk times 10. Excellent. It'll be nice to have a night's sleep without worrying about my flock. And or if you want, you can talk to me anytime. Or not. I'll talk. What's up? The sheep have been eating and sleeping better. They're yielding more milk, too. You've single-handedly saved my flock. What else do you want to talk about? That's all you want to talk about? Well, why would I talk to you anytime if you're just going to repeat yourself? All right. So, Let's get a move on. Let's go to the lab now, or whatever the official name of it is. I keep calling it a lab. The facility up top. Whatever. There maybe is a girl who lives there. And for some reason, that's a big, big deal. We went to the beach last time. Now we're going up to this path where we've been destined to go for quite a while now. And, what is that down there? It's a little... Just kind of looking. I don't know what I see. Sounds spooky. Alright, what's this? Alright, mind the lanterns. I do not mind them. I do not mind them. Alright, looks like a cold place is over there. I can wear the warm tunic though, if I need be. I'm looking over the edge as I walk. What does this say? Alright, enter at your own risk. Okay, I assume the risk by entering this place. That looks like an awesome telescope or something. So here I am. That's an ancient tech lab. I'm gonna do a quick once around. Is that the right phrase for it? This is a sunshroom, a bright red mushroom that grows in hot climates, imbued with the power of heat. They can also be used to cook dishes that will allow you to endure the bitter cold. There's a lizard here. I'm just gonna grab him. Hightail lizard. Alright, let's go in the front door. Probably be rude to go in the back. Feels like it could be a save spot. Hello! That guy just... Oh my god, they just appeared suddenly. Alright, what's up? It's Pura. Good evening. This is the Hateno Ancient Tech Lab. Do you have some business with the director? That's right, I do. The director is in the back. A terribly busy person, that one. Please try to keep it brief. Alright, sure. I will do that. What's this? This looks awesome. All this stuff looks cool. Hello, are you the director in the back? I'm just looking around before I make my final approach of the director. Hi.
Yeah.
It's Simon. Good evening. I imagine you've never seen so many books in one place. Pretty incredible, isn't it? We've gathered all of Hyrule's known literature on ancient civilizations here. As for the actual number of books, well... Is that thing on your waist? Is that a Sheikah? There's no mistaking it. That's a real Sheikah slate, isn't it? I've never actually seen one in person. If you could just show me the runes on it, I'd be most appreciative. So I'm like, sure, stasis. Ah, magnesis. Yes, yes. The remote bomb and Cryonis. What else? Let's see. So that's it for runes, but... strange. It doesn't seem like you have the basic runes. I don't understand why they're missing. There must be some reason. Where are my manners? I nearly forgot to introduce myself. My name is Simon. You are... Link, right? You know my name? Lady Impa caught me up to speed. You see, we were told a young man holding a Sheikah slate will appear, and you must do all you can to help him. He will be the hope that awakens the slumber of restoration. His name will be Link. Oh dear, I forgot to tell you something very important. Director, listen, Miss Director, this is a real Sheikah Slate. Director? Oh, that's right. I haven't introduced our director.
Oh.
Miss Pura happens to be right over there. She told me to go over here. As the Hateno Ancient Tech Lab director, Miss Pura is the world's foremost authority on ancient Hyrule culture. So, okay.
Check it.
All right. I have the utmost respect for Miss Pura, and she's all and all she's accomplished. I'm honored to be your assistant. On that note, Link, you see, the director may look like a young girl, but, well, maybe it's not my place to be telling you these things. You should talk to Miss Pura herself. Well, why'd she tell me to go over here? Fine, I'll go talk to you, but you better answer some questions. Look at all these books. All right. Hey, hey, are you surprised? The director of this laboratory is not Simon, it's me. Snappity snap. All right, you got me. Anyway, Linky, do you remember Linky, do you remember any dreams from your time in the Slumber of Restoration? You don't look like you've changed a bit in the last 100 years, but something must have happened in all that time. Well, no matter, I'm just happy you're still in one piece. Linky, what's that look? You do still remember me, right? I don't remember. Really? Well, I'm so shocked I don't know if I'll ever be able to recover from this. Even though 100 years ago I took you to the Shrine of Resurrection after Calamity Ganon fatally wounded you, even though I was the one who put you safely in the Slumber of Restoration, despite all that, you still don't remember me? I don't remember. As expected. After 100 years in the Slumber of Restoration, subject has lost all memories. Noted. Oh, sorry. I have a bad habit of taking notes rather abruptly like that. It's a charming quirk, isn't it? Anywho, do you have any questions for me? Aren't you a child? How very rude! Or perhaps it's not rude at all. I suppose it's actually a rather logical conclusion to jump to. The truth is, I look this way because of a failed experiment. Well, I say failed, but in some ways it was a success. I documented the full affair in my diary upstairs, but the whole thing is embarrassing, so I insist you refrain from reading it. Anyway, enough about that. Back to the topic at hand. Here you are, after 100 years. Here to defeat Calamity Ganon, who is growing in strength with every passing moment, and to rescue our beloved Princess Zelda, that is, if you've got the courage to try, and to help the one true hero, I, the one and only Pura, will restore the basic functions missing from the Sheikah Slate. And what do you say to that? Yes, please. I knew you'd say that. All right, then. First, I need you to run an errand for me. What's with that look on your face? You didn't think I'd fix your Sheikah Slate for free, did you? I guess I did, because, I mean, it seems to be like, post-slumber restoration subject is plagued by presumptuous tendencies, noted. I mean, I just think if you know you want me to save the world, you could at least just do this one thing for me. Let me explain what this errand entails. You know the unlit furnace on the wall just outside this laboratory? Could you please bring the blue flame from the ancient furnace in town, and also use it to light our furnace? This sweet little guidance stone will start working once you do that, allowing us to restore your missing runes. Huh, I wonder if young women these days still say things like sweet and little. Oh well, I suppose it doesn't matter anyway. Okay then, I'm counting on you for that blue flame. Alright. Hey, can I help you? Got any pointers? Blue flame makes it sound fancy, but it's really just the same as a regular flame. If it gets wet, that's that. It'll help you. It'll help to light the village lanterns you'll see on your way back here, to avoid steep inclines. Do you have any other questions? Ancient furnace. Yeah, you'll find the ancient furnace on the high ground behind Reed's house. As soon as you leave this laboratory, head left until you're at the cliff's edge, then make use of your scope. You'll see a blue flame. That's the ancient furnace. Do you have any other questions? And you are. I'm Pura. Snappity snap. It's one of her quirks, right? You weren't asking about my name. Oh, I get it. You want to know my age, don't you? Well, Linky, I must say, it's not polite to ask a young maiden such as myself her age. And also, don't ask me why I know so many ancient terms. And also, don't ask about my diary upstairs. Do you have any other questions? Nope. When bringing back the blue flame from the ancient furnace, you may find it helpful to use a torch. There should be one at the entrance of the house. Feel free to use it. All right. I will actually use it, probably. And I'm gonna go read her diary. Maybe. Is this the way? Wait, how do you get upstairs? How does one get upstairs? Let's go see. Here we go. I'm gonna go read the diary. Alright. I don't know. I guess I got that as a fast travel point, but I didn't beat it. That one over there, I did not beat. I went over to it. Which way did we go? To look over the cliff? Alright, here we are. Diary time. Research diary for anti-aging rune. Classified for pure eyes only. First page. Date? Question mark. Work has finally begun on my anti-aging rune. If all goes to plan, I believe it will effectively reverse the aging process. This technology will enable us to make retired warriors young again, thereby strengthening the Hyrulean army. When Calamity Ganon inevitably returns, we'll be ready. Our offense will be solid and our defense impenetrable. The need for this tech pains me, but I truly hope to use it to attain everlasting peace for all. Date? Question mark. The beta version of my anti-aging rune is complete. I've already added it to the Sheikah slate I made for myself. Since I am to be the test subject of this experiment, Simon booted up the rune and directed its rays at my body. After 20 seconds of exposure, I felt extreme fatigue and broke into a fever, forcing us to cease the experiment. Unable to stay awake, I went to bed immediately. Tomorrow, I will try to figure out why this went awry. Anti-aging experiment trial day 2. My extreme full body fatigue has slightly improved, for which I am grateful. Still, I do not recognize my face in the mirror. My hair is thick again and floor length. My wrinkles, once deep and as trenches, have vanished without a trace. It seems the anti-aging effect works. However, I did not expect the reversal to happen so frighteningly fast. This morning, I kicked Simon awake and had him run a full physical exam on me. My height, weight, vision, bone density, heart, blood. We tested everything we could, pushing the facility to our limit. Our discoveries were startling. My results were typical of a Sheikan woman in her early 50s. In other words, I reversed my age by more than 70 years in a single night. I can only hope I do not awaken to find I have the body of a newborn baby. Day 3. I awoke with an abundance of energy. It has been decades since I slept so well. Upon waking, I immediately checked the mirror, only to be greeted by a youthful version of myself. According to Simon's examination, I have the body of a Sheikah woman in her 30s. 30 years old! I was around that age when I was first able to continue my research following the Great Calamity. The first thing I did was try to figure out how to expand the functionality of the Sheikah sensor. I was around 80 years old when that expansion was completed. I intend to bequeath this tech to our sleeping hero. I hope to the gods that he'll be able to assist in the destruction of the calamity that swallowed our Princess Zelda whole. Okay, day 4. After today's routine physical, the results show that I have the body of a Sheikah woman in her 20s. I haven't felt this good in a century. This is all taking me back to when the Great Calamity happened. Ganon has been dormant for 10,000 years. Perhaps his power has been building all that time. The slaughter that followed was arbitrary and merciless. The destruction complete. We lost everything. Hyrule Castle. Princess Zelda. Well, perhaps not everything was lost. A youth named Link was brought to me 100 years ago, covered in wounds and on death's doorstep. Link, so young, yet so courageous. He was the youngest knight to have ever been appointed to the Imperial Guard at Hyrule Castle. He was also gifted a swordsman who was selected as captain of Princess Zelda's personal guard. I thought his skills would be enough to defeat Ganon in glorious fashion. Since ancient times, the royal family of Hyrule and us Sheikah researchers have a strong bond. Their path is our own. We took the swordsman and the Sheikah slate Princess Zelda left behind to the Shrine of Resurrection. Although the slumber of restoration had not been fully tested, we decided to put the swordsman under to save his life. It was the best we could do. Day 5. Here we go. This is exciting. I awoke to something horrifying, a scarlet lump scarring my otherwise youthful face. After analyzing this monstrosity, I came to the conclusion that it was just a pimple, a big one. The results of today's physical exam indicate that my body and mind have reverted to those of a teenager. I feel like Simon looks at me differently, which irritates me. I got angry when he insisted on running my blood test for me. I mean, really, what even? I could do it all by myself. In any case, I wonder what experiment I should focus on next. The blue flame in the furnace outside is growing weaker by the day. I do hope the guidance stone doesn't stop working. Day 6. My age reversal has progressed further still. I now look and feel like a 6-year-old. My height has regressed so much that I can no longer reach things in high places. It's super annoying. Where is that genius swordsman we placed in the slumber of restoration? Anyway, wake up already! If he doesn't awaken soon, my feature expansions for the Sheikah sensor will go to waste. But even if he does manage to wake up, how can I be sure he'll find me here? I want to go and just kick Linky awake, but I doubt Simon will help me. It'd be hard with my 6-year-old body anyway. Instead, I think I'll be working on a rune to unreverse my aging process. Day 7. This morning exam's results indicated that I'm still age 6, same as yesterday. Perhaps my age reversal has stopped. As luck would have it, today I also finished developing the beta version of my age-boosting rune. If successful, this should be able to reverse the effects of the anti-aging rune. I hope it will, anyway. All I need to do is increase the output and expose myself to its rays. However, when I tried to add this feature to the Sheikah Slate I made, I found that the guidance stone had stopped. What's more, the blue flame in the furnace outside has gone out. Man. I sent Simon to the ancient furnace, but he was too clumsy, and it was raining and nothing went to plan. So I had to go down there to help. But a girl in the village saw me. What a mess I've made. Not only am I unable to continue my research in this state, I can only work by the light of gas lamps. What to do? All right, stop reading. Wow, we read it all. Hope she's not behind me. Oh, God. Oh, my God. That scared me so much. Oh, my God. Jump scare. So, were all these papers here before? Oh, well. So where is I supposed to go? Does it go down the trail and look to the left? Yeah, there it is. Right there somehow, right? So what I do is I'm gonna go light it, I guess. Which is right down there. And I'll try to light the things along the way. And thankfully it's not raining right now. So there's the blue flame. Too bad I can't fly back, but there's a lantern. I don't know if I have to light all the lanterns, but all right. Nice. And there's one over here. I mean, I don't know if I have to do these. Oh. All right, let's see. I mean, am I doing this right? I think I am. Okay, this is so far so good. We're gonna light all this stuff. And if it goes out, then that's fine, because I'm gonna get these. I don't know if I have to light these, or if it's just like good manners. This is working out pretty well. All right, well, we're just gonna go. I know this is gonna take a little bit of time. But again, I thank you so much for being here. We're about to the end of this episode. It's been a long one again. I mean, we got a lot done. All right, there's another one. Just light it. I wonder, you know, if it's going to rain soon. I would hate for it to start raining. It would be terrible. I want to be able to finish this immediately. Hi. Hope you don't mind the light. And then we're going this way. I mean, this is pretty good. This is a pretty straightforward mission. Just go, you'll light it, and then we'll be delighted. Not that way. All right. I wonder if she's going to anti-age herself. All right. I don't know if there's any like reward for like lighting all of these or not, but I'm lighting several of them, so that's good. Boy, this is a long one. Sorry guys. Sorry that it's so taking so long. There we go. The blue flame, huh? I read the diary, by the way. got it. There we go. I think this is a fast travel plat. Yeah, it is a travel gate. Nice. All right. We got it. You read it, didn't you? I read it. Well, I commend your honesty. Still, it is never acceptable to rummage through a young lady's private musings. Got it? Naturally, you should be punished for that. Switch on. What? All Sheikah Slate runes have now been deleted. I completely deleted the data on your Sheikah Slate. Go on, take a look. Rude. Yep. Gotcha! Oh, she got me. A prank. Did you like my Guidance Stone impression? Superb, right? Don't young girls do mean impressions for fun? Maybe not. Oh, well. All right, so let's do this. Let's hit this up. Or maybe I'll have... Okay. Oh. Hey! Linky, thanks so much. Now then, take a look over there. The Guidance Stone must be starting to react. There's nothing mysterious about it. This is pure science. My sweet little Guidance Stone. You sure know how to make this old researcher's heart flutter. Well then, let's go ahead and restore those Sheikah Slate runes for you. Give me a nice snap. Go on. No time to be shy about it. Snap! Nice one. Okay then. Sheikah Slate repair underway. Guidance Stone lock removed. Now, let's do this thing. Oh my goodness, guys. Here we go. Get a new upgrade or something. I am ready. Sheikah Slate authenticating. Camera, Hyrule compendium, and album missing files confirmed. Starting repair. Here we go. So we are getting an upgrade here, right? Seems like it. Here we go. So what is this? Ooh, there we go. Instantly render a visible image into a picture. Pictures created are saved in the album. It is a useful feature that connects to the Hyrule Compendium and automatically registers pictures of new entries. What? What does that mean? A rune has been added. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. Are these old photos? What is this? Oh, creature. Oh, wow. Repair complete. All right. Well, cool. And it's done. So, is it all fixed up now? Let's see here. Which one is it? Camera, Hyrule Compendium, album. Yep, looks good. So, I know this is sudden, but hear me out. Take a picture of me with the camera. Oh, and don't forget to let me see it. All right, take my picture. Okay, let's then cycle through camera. All right, there she is. All right, take the picture. That's a good one. Saving the album. And then talk. Hey, how's the picture taking going? Did you get a cute pic of me with the camera? I took one. Ooh, I can't wait to see it. Let me see. So I let her see. Yep, looks good. My, who is this beautiful young creature? Huh? Oh, I guess it's my cue. Sorry, I kind of lost it there. It wasn't on purpose. It's not just a pretty girl in these images. Yes, there are also some old landscape photos stored in the album. I knew Princess Zelda had made frequent use of the camera feature, but this... Hey, Linky, it dawns on me that you were Princess Zelda's appointed knight, which means there's a strong possibility that you accompanied her to all the places where these pictures were taken. Oh, right. The lost memory thing could prove troublesome. But don't lose hope. It just means these pictures could be the missing piece to help you restore your lost memories. If my hunch is correct, I suggest you check in with Impa. She knows more about Princess Zelda than even I do. Oh, yeah. There's just one more thing I need from you. You don't have to worry about this until you see Impa, but I want you to bring me back some ancient materials. Bring them either to me or to Robbie at the Akala Ancient Tech Lab. As if my joy weren't enough, if you bring us ancient materials, we'll give you something good as a reward. All right, let's do this. Snap. Something on your mind? Something good? I'm glad you asked. If you bring me some ancient materials, I'll power up your runes. Interesting. You'll need 3 ancient screws to power up your Sheikah sensor. You need 3-inch shafts to power up your remote bombs. You'll need 3-inch cores to power up stasis. If we're on the same page, stop staring at me. Hurry up and bring me some ancient materials. All right, so I think... Okay, snap! I think you should go see Impa first, but if you're saying you already have some ancient materials, then why don't we go ahead and power up your Sheikah Slate? Ancient materials! Now then, in exchange for those ancient materials, I'll power up a rune on your Sheikah Slate. I'm game. So, which rune do you want to power up? Remote bomb, for sure. Since, yeah, probably, yes. Yes. Remote bomb, power up time, yahoo! For that, I'll need 3 ancient shafts. Yes. Hold it, stop everything. You don't have the... Darn, I don't have... I thought I would have them. Okay. So, which rune do you... Okay, so bye. Bye. I don't have them. Oh, man. Slate it for upgrades. I know. I know that there's a guy in town running around selling them, but... You know, there's only so much I can do. And for now, you know, go see Impa. And see what happens. Next episode. Hey, Simon. Good morning. What do you need? Bye. Okay, then. Well, guys, thanks so much for watching. I think we pretty much cleared up, you know, today's episode. One thing I want to do before we leave, I want to take a look at, what button is it? Nope. No, don't mess with that. There it is. So what do we have here exactly? We have an album. We have the Hyrule Compendium that features all these things that I either have or don't have. I don't know. Yeah, weird. Okay. And then we also have the album. I mean, these are all old pictures. Let's take a look at these. Yeah, some of these. I mean, are these familiar? I don't know. Maybe. What am I supposed to do with these? Am I supposed to go to them? Maybe so. Anyway, well, guys, again, thank you so much for watching. Come back next time for more. We'll travel on. Go see Impa. Maybe try to get some more parts. If we take a look at what I do have. Where are the ancient stuff? I'm just missing 1 ancient shaft. All right, that's fine. I have 3 springs, 4 screws, shaft, ancient gear. So, yeah, we got to go to get them done. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time for more. Goodbye. I'm Zach Scott. Subscribe if you have not. If you like this video and want to help this channel grow, all you got to do is click the like button below. Thanks so much for watching. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. This is Otto, Egon, and I'll see you next time for more.